Hi everyone, I'm Mahesh. In this video, we are going to discuss how to avoid some common mistakes as a Java beginner. The first one, forgetting to free resources. So this is a common mistake where one easily forgets closing the resources such as network connections, database connections, file streams, and so on. And this mistake may lead to resource leakage or memory leak by no longer used objects, right? So let's see an example here. I have a method here, copy file. So which actually copies a file from source to destination. So you can see the entire code is written in try catch block. And I have some source channel and destination channel, two objects of file channel class. And I'm using transfer to method to copy the file from source to destination. So I have a main method here where I'm calling this copy file. And you can see here, I am actually copying the file one here to the same location. And my new file name is file2.txt. So let's see what file1.txt has. So it has some text here. So this file has to be copied and the new file name should be file2.txt, right? So let me execute it. And you can see copy is successful and we can see here a new file got created with the same text. So this code works fine, right? So, but if you observe here, this code actually misses the statements for the closure of source channel and destination channel. So we missed closing these two resources. So how to avoid this mistake is, so we have a concept called try with resources introduced in Java 7. So with that, we can actually, what we can do here is, so the syntax of it is, we can actually declare these resources, right? So these resources along with try. So the syntax of it is, we should enclose this resource, declaration of these resources within try, so that Java takes care of closing these resources once you are out of this try block. And the only condition to use these resources along with try is, so these classes or the resources, so should actually implement the auto closable interface. That's the only condition we have here. And with that, so only that's the only condition and we don't need to change anything else. So let me execute it and show you. So we already have file two, right? So let me name it as file three and execute the program. And you can see file three got created here. So meaning file one is copied to file three and the only change we did was, so we actually adjusted the syntax. So the entire code along with the resources was within the try block. So we took that into the try. So try, which we call it as try with resources, right? So with that, what happens is Java takes care of closing these resources. You don't need to explicitly close the resources. Even though you forget to close the resources, Java automatically takes care of it when we use try with resources. And the next one is ignoring exceptions. So you can see a piece of code here where I have X and Y as integers and we are reading the command line arguments as input and converting these arguments into integers and then summing up these two integers and outputting this sum on the console, right? So let me execute this program and we can't execute this program like how we do normally as we wanted to pass the input from the command line, right? So for that, I can open the terminal. So terminal is an inbuilt command line tool within the IntelliJ. So here we can run the program, right? So Java, and we need to provide the fully qualified class name here. Three dot mistake two. And we need to pass the arguments. So let me pass two numbers, something like this. And you can see the output here. Sum is 468, right? So let me run it again with some invalid input, meaning like I'll provide the first argument as integer. My second argument is a string. So let me execute this. You can see we got the output, right? But this is not correct. So this is the incorrect result. So why this happened is, if you go to the code and verify, we had the entire code written in try catch block, but if you notice, we had the empty catch block here. So that's the reason this mistake went unnoticed. So how to handle this type of mistake is, within the catch block, we should not leave it as empty, but we should actually print something within the catch block, like something like number format exception occurred, or we can actually print the stack trace as well. So that even though we get the incorrect result, we get a hint by looking at the print stack trace that something went wrong in the program. So let me execute it again now. And this time you can see the output, right? So we got the output, but we also got the exception here, number format exception for input string, the particular string, right? So this gives us a hint that something went wrong in the program, right? So the bottom line is, so whenever we have a try catch block, do not leave the catch block empty. At the least, print the stack trace. And this is again one of the most common mistakes one does. So modifying the collection while iterating it. So here is an example where I have a list of strings here. You can see the list of strings, and I'm converting this list into the array list. And you can see I'm trying to iterate this list. So read each element from the list and have a condition here. If my element contains the letter E, then I am actually removing such element from the list. So let me execute this. Here you can see we are getting concrete modification exception. This is because we are trying to modify the collection while we are iterating it. And Java prohibits this kind of operation for two main reasons. So the first one is the list size is changed dynamically when you remove an element, and this causes the iteration behaving unpredictable as the content of the list gets changed. And the second reason is, imagine in a multi-threaded program, while one thread is accessing this list and another thread is removing elements from this list, again the result will be unpredictable, right? So is there any solution for this? Yes, there are few. So the first one is, we can have a list, another new list created, where we can add the elements which we wanted to remove to this list and then iterate over the list to remove these elements. So you can see here I have created a list and adding to this list which are all the elements to be removed, and later we'll actually loop through the entire original list and we'll remove the list of the fruits which we wanted to remove. So let me execute this now. See, we are getting the output here. So the fruit containing E should be removed. That's the condition here. So apple and cherry are the fruits which contains the letter C. So they are removed and we got the output here. Here is a more compact solution where we use an iterator. Iterator is an interface which is designed specifically for modifying the collection while iterating its elements. So you can see I created an iterator object, assigned the list to it. So I have a while loop here, iterating through all the elements and reading each element and verifying in that element, if that element contains letter E, then we are going to remove that element from the list. So you can see the output, correct output here. So this is how we should be handling, or we should be modifying the collection while iterating. So these are some of the common mistakes by a Java beginner and how to avoid them. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.